see.
Others into doing the fighting for her.
Control seems to kick in when you get hit by that creepy ghost thing.
Be careful you don't get jerked around too, okay? That beast is the only thing standing between you and the server room. You've got to take her out!
Snake, this is Mantis we're talking about.
The fight on Shadow Moses?
That's right. Back then, we defeated him by using multiple controller ports to counteract his mind-reading powers. Snake, try using the same tactic again. Plug the controller into controller port 2.
It's not gonna work, Roy.
Huh?
Do you see any controller ports here? Deceiving Mantis is going to take more than simply pushing the PS button to switch controller numbers.
But then, that means...
It's impossible. Sorry.
Well, be damned. Well, so much for the controller. But that beast has another weak spot. Do you remember what it is?
Weak spot? You mean the bust modeled on Mantis's true face? The one with all the leather bands wrapped around it?
That's the one. Mantis always hated seeing his birth face. Attack that bust and break off the leather seal.
Colonel, I can't do that.
Sure you can. Seeing his true face is sure to break Mantis's concentration.
There's no bust. What? There is no bust here to attack.
You're kidding.
Snake. Remember how Psycho Mantis controlled Meryl using telepathy? Well, I'm thinking this thing does it by manipulating the nanomachines inside a target's body, forcing them to secrete opioids and sending them into hypoesthesia. In other words, she puts them into a sleepwalking state and controls their muscle systems directly.
What is that ghost-looking thing anyway?
My guess? A hologram, meant to intimidate people. Having some freaky thing like that suddenly pop up in front of you is enough to make anybody jump.
Like how special forces dress all in black when they go on a raid.
The control signals for the nanomachines must be embedded in the laser used to create the hologram. That's probably why Mantis can't control you unless you touch it.
But she's controlling dead guys, too. What about that?
Same concept. Didn't you ever do that experiment in high school where you attach electrodes to a dead frog's leg to make it twitch? The nanomachines are capable of storing an electric charge. It's entirely possible that Mantis is using that electricity to make muscles contract. If she really is controlling people through their nanomachines, you know a way to counter that, right? Give it a try.
The women of the B&B Corps. One laughed, one raged, and one cried. And now the final beast, who won't stop screaming. That wailing may be the product of some unendurable fear that's gnawing away inside of her. I can't even imagine what kind of trauma would cause a person to scream like that.
Ah!
Come on! I hear them in my head. The screams! Make them stop! I don't want to hear them anymore! I'm scared. I'm so scared! My head hurts. It hurts. I'm sorry. Get out of my body. Forgive me.